Penguin Random House Audio presents Hivestruck. This is the author, Vincent Toro. To Grisel, as always, and to all the brown cyborgs everywhere. Are we humans mere machines to manufacture machines better than ourselves? Ernesto Cardenal. C. Because they love the pixel, not the hero. Hito Steil. I, Ars Poetica, Micro God Schism Song. Robot Pilgrim Colonic, Illicit Volt Rot, Motor Imp, Six Digit Pinprick, Sonic Broom, Scoop Fool's Gold from Slipshod Mind Pod, Pick Locks of Cobalt Roost, Phototropic Bliss, Phonic Distortion, Tinfoil Trolls in Wi-Fi Torpor, Oblong X, Box Flips Ribs into Port Prisons or Simforts, Iris Lit with Nook Prisms, Whip 2 Million Gig Pistol, Piston Shift from Groin to Droid Rods, Zip Witch or Whiz Kid, Proto Snob Incision, Toxic Pools of Blown Skin Trips, Thin Fission of Word from Window, Mint Condition Solipsism, Ion Suit Loops, Bitcoin Cops Kissing Biochip Gridlock, Nitric Worm Hollow, Info Mortis. Such acceleration produces fusion. Octavio Paz. Uggs are so 5 minutes ago. So too are Crocs. I threw out my pair before anybody knew they had been made. Just 98 seconds after I bought them. Fresh is old, tú sabes. Like on Fleek, or Scallywag and Greaser. Like my abuela's Tinder profile. Yo, I can't get with foxtail suits. The new neon space jumpers. My foxtrot, now buried in the basement with my running man. My Charleston. No one uses those formats anymore, don't you know? They're mad outdated. Like CDs, or cassettes, or live symphony orchestras, or Reason. Though all the really cool bands are now releasing their albums on papyrus sheet music. Those days, which are these days, my folks are hooked on WhatsApp, while mi sobrina says for her 11th birthday, she just wants a daguerreotype machine and the chance to hike device-free this Sunday, which is already last Monday. I'm told realism is back and abstract minimalism is better left as set pieces in period films from a time no one seems to remember. And besides, no one goes to films anymore. But I hear the silent era is fixing to make a spectacular comeback, and cuneiform is about to cancel Moho. Today, human resources is scanning job applications using an algorithm that discards the resumes of candidates older than the age of 15. And those 15-year-olds better be able to prove they have no experience and at least 2 million followers. Though HR says they're all for hiring anyone who's already been dead at least 70 years. But they've got to be willing to start in the mailroom. But oh, I also heard mailrooms are relics and fiber optics are obsolete, that nano is the next old thing. My kid brother is already hooked. He asked for a candelabra and a wind-up music box for his sweet 43rd. What, then, is the current trend, you ask? Stare down that tunnel up ahead. In 20 seconds, you'll see a train that's headed for the last century. Union busting last Friday becomes Matawan next Tuesday. The Bolshevik Revolution and Bolivian independence will be held up as both errors of the past and triumphs of the future. The French symbolists are the future's hot girl summer, nah mean? Nah, they're so passé. Haven't we seen that done before, next Tuesday? Comic books are suddenly trends for the nursing home. What we'll say in a decade is already out of fashion. It's like everyone is pining to be the flavor of the millennium. But which one? Trending items dissolve into the ether faster than hydrogen sulfide. We're already bored with what hasn't happened yet. binge watch. Caught the season, Hale. Finale of So You Think, Hale. Ninja Idol, The Housewives of Hale. Abby, A Young Soldier Was, The Distracted. Baking When, The Over. A spurned lover informed him of his mother's cancer. Then a shot clock buzzed, stimulated. The ball hovered desperately like a caped, the cross. Wizard at 0 hour, the under. Soon a school hallway, nourished, broke into song and their allergy. Venomous creatures to action, ascended from sewers has calmed. While co-workers cast aside etiquette to kiss, the avalanche. 10 doors over, somatic. Teen mothers are castigated. Emergency surgery, amused, is performed without anesthesia. The front, crew, gate, hunts for the world's weirdest sandwich. A neighbor was left open. Cracks wise, a drug deal for us, goes awry. Widows bicker at the dead to walk in. Gladiators Bob and Rob. In spandex across synthetic foam battlefields. News lands with the starstruck, a joke. A bomb is diffused mere seconds before it was rigged to detonate. Wax sealant is sold to the desolate, the nonplussed. Hail, 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 the distracted, the overstimulated, the cross, the undernourished. Their allergy to action has calmed the avalanche. Somatic, amused. The front gate was left open for us to walk in and rob the starstruck, the desolate. A brief history of my screens. My first screen was large enough to fit me inside its mandibles. Immobile, it weighed as much as a baby rhino. It poked me with grainy sculptures of showrooms filled with domestic wares, begging me to guess how much they cost. How much? My second screen was smaller, though still unable to migrate with me to untenable borders. The lines were sharper, like a spaghetti strainer where I tried to sneak my broken action figures through. It always refused to go dark when bedtime came to arouse me. My next screen did not belong to me or to any relatives. He was a stowaway in the front room I shared with two flatmates. Or maybe I was the stowaway. One of them could always be seen trying to wedge themselves into the tubes, vying for space among the cliques that this screen promised would make us all beautiful. My fourth screen was desperately lonely. We mostly kept it turned off because we were too busy falling in love. And besides, it had terrible reception. My fifth screen, Gremlin, multiplied until there were more screens than rooms. They, too, despise sunlight, water. Devoted, they have learned to be a walk through Tokyo streets, a Pacific beach, or even an eagle's nest. Fluorescent bomb for analog chafing, my pores engorged by their lucent marvels, until I became a twisted nomadic hominid, living liquid crystal shroud. So much time spent looking, looking, searching, hoping something, anything, was looking back. Panopticon Federacy. He longs to discover a nook of the couch where no living thing might find him. A place occupied by the swarm of jump cut edits where thin men launch themselves down traffic storms with cardboard signs and fists full of conviction. Each angle offers him pastiche, where the ungroomed dance to silent rhythms, circling the local pharmacy with only their grimace to protect them. Their need to press against each other and urge neighbors to throw up their arms bedevils him, or it makes him bitter. Or perhaps it makes him sanguine. Sanguinely bitter to be told they demand a seat at the feast where bloodstains become poker chips. Or so he is told.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.